to subtract these rational expressions, we need to get common denominators. And as you can see, denominators are very different. The first one is x, and the second one is x squared minus 4x. So in order to figure out how to get a common denominator, we need to factor all of our denominators where factorable. So you can't factor x. X is x. So the second one we can factor. So we can factor out an x, and then we'll have left x minus 4 in parentheses. So let's look at it this way. The first denominator is an x, and the second denominator is x times x minus 4. So we can use the least common denominator of x times x minus 4. So in order to get a common denominator of x times x minus 4 in the first rational expression, we just need to multiply it by x minus 4. If we multiply the top and bottom by x minus 4, in the bottom we'll have x times x minus 4, and at the top we'll just have x minus 4. Then let's just rewrite the second rational expression, because our denominator was already what we needed it to be. And then now we're going to combine the top. So we have x minus 4 minus x divided by x times x minus 4. So we can combine like terms at the top. We have x minus x, which is 0. So at the top we just have negative 4 divided by x times x minus 4. So that's going to be our final answer. We can't simplify that any further. So we have now subtracted the two rational expressions. You could, if you wanted to, distribute the x back and get x squared minus 4x, but there's really no need to do that. So we can leave our answer like this.